Hi, and welcome to our brief overview of the energy monitoring and power management component within the latest version of NetSupport DNA. As you can see on the screen, we've selected the energy monitoring component and we've selected a date criteria of this week. On the main view, we can see total energy used inside of work hours, as well as total energy used out of hours. And from our detail view below, we can expand to see, in this example here, the individual PCs, the time that they've been powered on, how much of that was in and out of hours, energy used, cost of energy used, and of course their CO2 footprint. And this information here adjusts depending on which part of the hierarchy we select within our main tree view. Now, as well as producing reports on energy used across the school or your organization, perhaps more importantly within our power management feature is we provide the ability to select departments and configure not only energy costs, but also our power management rules. Let's drill down from our example here and pick a department, the curriculum department. If I select again from my energy monitoring menu and I pick settings, you'll see for the curriculum department, I have power management enabled. As a starting point, I've enabled power management. I've then enabled power on, and the green line reflects when computers will be powered on. In this example here, the machines are set to power on at 7:45. Now, the first thing I should do is turn off Saturdays and Sundays, because clearly those machines we don't want to turn on at a weekend. In this fictitious example, let's pretend that I've got 1,000 computers in my curriculum department. I might choose to stagger powering those machines on if I'm in an old school building where there's a risk I might trip the power by having too many machines starting all at once. Similarly, I can choose when to power off those curriculum machines at the same time. And if the machine is logged on, I can choose what I want to do. Suspend it, do nothing, and shut down, the same when it's logged off. So this gives me additional controls based on the condition of the machine. Now, one of the bits of feedback we got from schools was, this is really, really useful, but I have to remember to disable it when there's a bank holiday or school holidays. So in the latest version, we've added the ability to prevent the power management working during holidays. And by selecting the holidays dialog, you'll see we can define our holiday periods at the bottom. Let's hit set. And you'll see in this example, we've defined the summer holiday, the summer half term, and the May bank holiday. And again, we can build up a list appropriate for our school or organization of any holiday periods where we don't want our automated power management to apply. Let's say okay and close back from that. No need to save anything, and we'll return to our settings for the curriculum department. Now, power management is step one, turning machines on at a predefined point in the day and turning them off. The second level is what we do with machines that are inactive for a period of time. And again, within NetSupport DNA, we provide inactivity monitors. We provide up to two policies, and for each policy, which are defined based on the colors on the screen. So here, policy one is our yellow slider, and it is set to run from 5:15 in the evening through to midnight. The policy says, if any PC is inactive for more than 30 minutes, if the machine is logged off, shut it down. Of course, we could say do nothing or suspend it. Or if it's logged on, we'd ask the machine to be suspended. Again, we could log it off, shut it down, or do nothing. Similarly, we could have a second policy that runs during the day. And if we enable policy two and say we'll have that policy running, we could perhaps drag that policy, as I'm doing here, and say it runs throughout the day to this point here, and we can set a different level of threshold during typical teaching times. Finally, we have the option to warn our users that they're about to be logged off if their machine is going to be shut down or suspended, and give them the option to postpone that process, which of course by default we would want to give them. Again, the main philosophy behind NetSupport DNA is making things very simple and easy to use, and to ensure that the UI and the way that the configuration is applied is as logical and intuitive as possible. And that's pretty much it. A few clicks, 2 or 3 minutes effort, and you can have power management enabled across your campus.